Hey guys, this is Clyde Cartman here, and today we'll be taking in a look at the newest development in the PS4 Jailbreak scene, which is the 7.50 to 7.55 exploit released on the second week of March. First of all, is it stable? And should you upgrade to 7.50 or 7.55? So you should stick around till the end of the video to find out. Alright, first things first, just a big disclaimer. You will experience a thing called KPs or kernel panics. It is normal, do not worry. While doing the jailbreak, specifically at the WebKit exploit part, your PS4 might freeze and you will either have to pull the plug or the PS4 will shut down by itself. While this may not necessarily affect the PS4 in general, it will however at least affect the health of your hard drive. And you may need to rebuild your database if ever, so I would highly recommend having a backup copy of your hard disk drive. Personally, I have never experienced this, but your mileage may vary and you have been warned. Alright, so what you're gonna do first is find a host for the exploit. All of the links for the host that I've tried will be in the description below. Also, another disclaimer here, the host that you choose will not affect the success rate of the jailbreak, since all of the hosts that I've tried basically still use the same WebKit exploit, or at least the updated one by SDERSGOVI. Most likely, they will all have the same success rate, and the host that you choose will be up to your preference. Alright, so open your PS4's browser. In this video, I will be using Night King's host as an exploit. Again, links in the description below. I would highly recommend that you bookmark the website first. And something that I did not do in the first attempt is clear my cookies and clear the website data. To do this, while on the browser, press Options button on the controller and then Settings, clear cookies, and then clear website data. Just to get you in on the news as well, last night Sistro has released GoldHEN for 7.50 to 7.55 exploit, and that's what I'm trying upon the creation of the video. I find that it is much more stable to use than the initial releases of Mira. Alright, so what you want to do next at least would be to click on the GoldHEN button at the page of Night King's host, and it will take you to this blank screen. An important thing to note here is to not press anything unless the PS4 shows you the not enough free memory error, and you will receive that message quite a lot, so just keep trying. Do not lose hope until it shows you the found fake validation message. Now, it is still possible at this point to get the memory error, but once you have gotten the string implementation corrupted successfully on the page, the next thing you'll be encountering would be most likely the KP or the kernel panic. Now in this attempt, as you can see, my PS4 actually KP'd and I had to pull the plug in order to get it to run again. And as you can see, as soon as I powered up my PS4, it went into checking into safe mode and checking the system storage status. One of the downfalls of this exploit is this part, as it will at least take a minute or two to completely boot up the PS4 again. Alright, so now that we are set up and running again, just pretty much do the same thing. Go to your PS4 browser, clear the cookies and website data, then go to the website of the exploit host, then GoldHEN. You'll know that you're good to go if the waiting for client notification pops up, followed by the you are all set window pop up, and lastly, the launching payload notification will be the last indication that you are good to go. Now, it is actually worth looking into that after the you are all set window pop up, you may experience a kernel panic at that moment. This is based from my experience with the first and latest versions of Mira, but as for the GoldHEN edition or the GoldHEN exploit, I still have not experienced that. Alright, so final thoughts. Is the jailbreak stable? Well, as of the moment, it is not stable. But was it better than the initial release of the exploit? That is a definite yes. I remembered before I had to go through like 10kps back then just to get Mira to load properly. And now at least 1, 2, or 3kps, that is a lot better than before. And now, would I recommend you to upgrade your firmware to at least 7.50 or 7.55? As of now, that is a no. Since the games and the updates from this firmware are already being backported to 5.05 or 6.72, I would definitely advise you guys to just stick with what you have, since from what I know, the previous firmwares have a better exploit stability than this one that we have. So for me, I only stopped upgrading my PS4 Slim when I got the 7.55 version. That is why I was stuck at this version no matter what and just kept it until finally, at the 13th of March 2021, Slayer's GoldHEN finally released the public exploit. So if you have enjoyed this first video that I released, please give this a like and subscribe to my channel. I am Clyde Cartman, definitely it is my first time jailbreaking my PS4, and I can't wait to share some of the further developments along the line. Make sure you subscribe to my channel and have an awesome day. Peace out.